find that athletes want to focus on the second and the third pole, but the first pole, in my opinion, is the most critical. If we start in a good position, the likelihood that we'll finish in one is really great. So my first tip today is going to be to find a good setup position. We're going to go with the last lace of our shoe being under the bar. We're going to make sure that we sit our hips nice and low and try and elevate our chest nice and tall. A lot of times what we see is when athletes go to execute that first pull, their hips shoot up similar to what you'd see in a deadlift. An example of that would be this. As you can notice, when I'm doing this, my chest is down, and if my chest is in vertical, prepare for the jump that's going to happen in the snatch or the clean in the Olympic lifts. So what my first focus tip for you is going to be, execute a good starting position. What that should look like is my hips stay low, and I'm trying to generate power through my inner thighs. What that helps me do is keep a nice vertical or more of a straight up chest as opposed to eyes looking down.
No.
We're going to go over the second pull. So the goal of the first pull really is to just help us get to the second pull. A lot of times we see our athletes have some faults where on the first pull, they're focusing on just pulling the bar off the floor as fast as they can. Their chest isn't as upright as they can have it, or they hit their knees. So the focus on the first pull is going to be to help us get to the second pull. Here for the second pull, we're trying to really focus on starting to create speed, power, and just keeping the bar close to the body. So what the second pull is going to look like, we should have our chest over the bar. Ladies, if you're wearing a sports bra, I like to think about having my sports bra over the front of the bar. And what we're going to do is we're just going to find this high hang position. As we get comfortable, we're just going to practice adding some speed to that. You can see I'm fully extending my hips, and now I'm just going to add in the high pull. Bar staying close to my body. Now I want you to think about from the knee to the upper thigh as a takeoff. This is where we're looking to create power and generate speed. All right, and the last pull that we have in the snatch, we call the third pull, or where we're actually pulling ourselves under the bar. What we're going to work on here is going to be a tall snatch. I'll show you what the pull under the bar looks like first, and then I'll show you the drill to help you perfect that. So the pull under is going to be, once I'm actually here, and I'm pulling myself under the bar. So one of the faults we see with athletes is they don't pull themselves under the bar quickly. We've got two drills to help work on the turnover. Have for you today to work on the third pull, getting under the bar, is going to be what we call a tall snatch. What that looks like is we'll be at full extension. So my hips are all the way extended. I'll have my snatch grip. And what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to work on being quick and aggressive underneath the bar. So again, I'm at full extension and I'm just looking to pull myself underneath the bar quickly.